Saturday. Well, I've been having fun so far. As you can see, listening to the Oppenheimer music. Welcome to Saturday's bit of live composition. The reason I have that up is because I am writing to this brief this morning. So, countless years have been marked by unpredictability and doubt. The onset of this particular year appears even more enigmatic. It is during such uncertain times that artists delve into the depths of their creative wells, extracting ideas from the intangible. In defiance of the common ways, common patterns and common flow of time, let us depart into uncharted territories, a rhythmic departure from the familiar 4/4 time signature. Let's embark on a musical journey that mirrors the essence of uncertainty, unease and unresolved emotions. Guided by unconventional time signatures, we weave together an album that encapsulates the spirit of our era, whether it be the grandeur of orchestral arrangements, the pulsating beats of synthwave, an epic cue, probably where I'm heading, or any other genre that beckons. Let our compositions echo the complexity of the present moment. As the creative process unfolds, allow the currents of inspiration to carry you to unexplored destinations. Embrace the unknown. See where the river takes you. And then I've got two references that the library's given, one being the Oppenheimer score and the Furiosa Mad Max trailer, starting at 1:03. So that is what has been requested, the style of music. I did actually do a little bit of the first track I did of this. It was varying time signatures. I'm going to go away from that today. And we are going to mess up time signatures rather than tempo. So, where's this going to take us? It's going to take us to the saving dialogue to start with. Something entitled EPIC ORCHESTRAL, it would appear. As required, coffee, but it's getting low. So maybe a short break at some point to refill that. Ever so important. Right. So I have Logic Remote fired up on my iPad. I also have I don't have it open. Because I've got an old iPhone 8 that I use just for the touch screen to power OSC bridge, which means I have fader control on the iPhone, which can control the various parameters in different instruments. I'm going to need a pair of headphones, I think. Otherwise, we're not getting anything done. Hopefully you can hear what is happening. Do feel free to make any suggestions as we go along. What do I want to do? I would like to do a piano sketch. Excuse me. I've had a sore throat all week, and it's finally this Saturday morning I actually seem to be able to speak, which is a pleasant change. Looks like there's sound coming through. So let's have a look at what we can come up with. Doesn't need to be poppy, it needs to be a bit epic. Doesn't necessarily need to be minor. So we could stick to D Dorian, so D minor, we've got, basically it's all the white notes, but your root is a D, so you've got D minor, E minor, F, G, A minor, B diminished and C that go over the D. One thing I did notice about the Oppenheimer score was the chords didn't massively change. They tended to stick to a pedal tone. So I am tempted to do that as well. Okay, let's not put anything down just yet. Remind us that's the piano. Is that how you spell grandeur? Grand evil, yes. Okay. An obvious place to start for most things is, oh, if you're watching this at the end of February 24, have you noticed that Spitfire Audio have just released their Symphony Orchestra collection for, I think, the intro price is $399. The normal price can be $499, but $500 for their, what used to be basically their flagship. You're talking like £3,000-£5,000 worth of stuff when it was originally released. That is currently their latest offering, and professional composers still use it today. So if you haven't invested in something like BBCSO, now it's a great time to pick something like that up. So I'm thinking violas because they're a bit less obvious, a bit lower. Give us a nice sort of subtle intro. So I always start on bar two, because that leaves a bar to send any MIDI information or setup information. Plus, when exporting it, I will always bump that back. So it's like a fraction, half a second of silence before anything comes in. Let's just get something down. What I should have done is actually checked that was responding. Oh, there we go. That is responding to the iPhone 8 controls. So you've got actual dynamic velocity there, and then the strength, the expression on the other controller. So you can move those in and out to create a bit of movement. Always remember to do that before the start of the bar as well when you're recording, otherwise it will suddenly jump. Go. That is literally a sustained D. All that was. Now, if we are going EPIC, Colossus is always a good library. So we could drink some coffee while that loads. Tremolo is always a good combination. Put that on top. So you notice I did some pulsing at the end there. In fact, before we go too far, let's change this up into 5/4. That second note come in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or should we go the full 5? Let's leave it for now. It should probably go to the end of the bar. Finish those. So try and remember what these things are. So Colossus Tremolendo, that was it, Flautando? Yeah. You could make this more in your face by putting the violin one leader in there and sort of close miking it. It's another option. What we're trying to do is just build up some tension. What I'm keen to do actually is try and find percussion that may help us out here, and the obvious place to start looking for that is in damage. So let's see what weird and wonderful things damage can come up with us. Or come up with for us. This is the fun bit of composing. See, I haven't even pressed anything, and that's quite inspiring. I haven't even chosen a patch. That's just the car chase, Manhattan car chase. Okay, some of these are quite out there. In general, damage is laid out that the lower notes are lower sounds and the higher ones tend to be higher pitched. So we've got a choice in the loop designer of straights or triplets, and that will come in useful for overlapping different rhythmic ideas. So let's go hybrid cinema. I quite like having the choice of high, mid, or low. So what I was trying to do there is actually increase the velocity as we went. I think the first one was way too low. Pretty good. One is supposed to be even louder. So back to the beginning. Okay, so we're coming up with a bed sort of sound at the moment. I wonder if actually we need something to overlap these. Possibly, yeah, let's change to a mid or maybe a high. Maybe in triplets. Let's see what's here. Wow. I think that's going to work. Now, there's going to need to be some sort of theme. And that is going to be started off by an instrument. What instrument, I hear you ask? That is exactly what I'm wondering. Could it be horns? Or do we want it a bit more subtle with woodwinds? I may break this down and go to BBC to pick out clarinets or oboes, bassoons. See what we can come up. Thank you. I quite like that, but it's the wrong instrument to do it on. It's probably going to work on strings. Remember, we're working in 5/4 here as well. So we're working in 5/4. May alter what we do here. Tempted for the time being to just come up with a theme. Let's just tighten those up. I like playing much of it in as possible because it varies the velocities. Tends to help. And what I've done there, stupidly, is played in 6 notes, isn't it? Get rid of those. Don't repeat the same mistake. As I want four lots or five. What about with the percussion back in? Nice. I think it was spiccato. Yeah. Okay. So now something that's going to act in, let's think, 4-4 maybe, over the 5-4. Let's give that to high strings. So I need to come up with something. Again, I'm going to turn the metronome back on and the rhythm off. Try something. Going too fast. So that naturally comes to the end. Thank you. there. Yeah, because we have five loops of it in 5/4. Therefore, for it all to end at the same time, just trying to think what is going to go over the top of that now. Still need a theme. Let's go back to the BBC SO. Just loop that for a second and try and come up with something. Thank you. Okay, I think I've come up with something. Took a good 5 minutes of noodling. But essentially, changing the chord we're on. So these parts are going to have to change. Then I'm going to have to come in with a theme. Do-do-do. So this is all on D minor. Get rid of that. Did start on D minor. Then I went up to F, G minor, and B flat for some sort of resolution, stroke climax. Who knows? So let me just show you what I'm thinking of there. The D minor with the added fourth. Maybe that sort of diminished on the B flat. Maybe. I'm gonna need a rhythmic pattern for this. Nearly. So we're now going to have to remember to join in. So going up to F. C. Going to glue these together. Right, so we got D, F, G, I've gone too quick then. B flat, and of course we don't need those notes. Should probably make sure that goes to the end of the measure. Let's put the percussion back in and see what we've got so far. Okay, interesting. Probably want to be changing. Yeah, probably is I quite like that pedal note on the D. Just wonder, is that becoming a bit too happy? Thank you. How to get a melody out of that? Four, three, one, seven. We stick to the 5/4. Thank you. Okay. I think I know what I want to do. But it's going to involve more coffee. Because that works well as a nice build. How long have we got to? 40 seconds minus a bit. So that's pretty good for a intro build. What I would like to do actually is build up some layers first before we start varying the chords. I mean, we may build on that idea. I'm not sure if that's too happy though. That F. Happier going to the A minor. You happy? Record that while I don't forget it. Save it for later though. Thank you. No. I want that. But I don't want it to... I don't want it to move the second time. Did want it to move. And then something to end that on. We've gone from that could work quite nicely. Something like that. Right. While you come up with some ideas, you'll notice I have run out of coffee. Pop, pop, pop. Which I'm going to refill. And leave this on the loop for you so you can hear what's happening. Ideas in the chat, welcome, please. Thank you. Okay, back in the room with coffee, but more importantly, Jaffa cakes. Yum yum. Okie doke. We need some building to do. Which is going to go from here. So just for sake of convenience, I'm going to pop the instruments here. Which probably makes sense. So we're probably we're going to bring brass in first. With some hairpins. Sounds nice. Do that, they either need to be shorter or quicker. Completely the wrong place. G, C sharp, F. Should have been. Thank you. possibly don't need that at the end. Because we're going to have something else underneath it in the name of Trombiones. Question is, which ones? Solution. I'm going to play them in. Don't forget to label things. Next. Do we need some guitars and synths? Maybe. What have we got? Let's put some emotion into it, shall we? What are the guitar textures like? Oh, if you're ever doing latch mode to record automation, don't forget to put it back to read, because later on you will accidentally overwrite it. Not that I have ever done that before. What are the guitar effects like? interesting effect. How close was I? Miles off. Because I'm wondering, can I apply some effects to this? Let's have a go. We'll be right back. Right. The question is, what's going to happen to the high end? Answer, no idea. What can we have some fun with? Quite good fun. Down a bit because it's a higher pitch note. coming up on an hour, 2 hours. Just for fun, I think that should fade in. Thing I left the piano in, but I think I quite like it. Wasn't really supposed to be there. What does it sound like from the beginning without it? Think from an orchestrally hybrid point of view, I prefer it without. Let's save that as it is. There you go. A couple of hours playing around, all good fun. And that is the start of some sort of epic orchestral thing that is trying to invoke some of these things, so a rhythmic departure from the 4-4. Unconventional time signatures weaving an album together, spirit of our era, fun stuff like that. There you go. I will put this as a video so people can find it. If you haven't liked and subscribed, why not? If you get notifications on as well, you'll find out when I do more of these live streams and all the other fun stuff that I'm playing around with at the moment, including VR and doing some simplified versions of tunes that I play in my band, stuff like that. Right, that's it for Saturday Music School. Catch you next time. Bye for now.